हेलो, आई एम प्रोफेसर डॉक्टर सतीश कुमार काशी, वालचंद इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी सोलापुर, प्रेजेंटिंग अ टॉपिक इंटरबेसिन ट्रांसफर ऑफ वाटर फॉर नेशनल डेवलपमेंट ऑफ इंडिया, NWDA's नेशनल परस्पेक्टिव प्लान। लर्निंग आउटकम्स ऑफ दिस सेशन, द स्टूडेंट्स विल बी एबल टू डिस्क्राइब NWDA's नेशनल परस्पेक्टिव प्लान ऑफ इंटरबेसिन ट्रांसफर ऑफ वाटर, describe advantages of Himalayan river development component of National Perspective Plan, and they will also be able to describe the advantages of peninsular river development component of National Perspective Plan. Introduction to Interbasin Transfer of Water. India has limited land and water resources. It is necessary to increase food production from 200 million tons to 500 million tons up to 2050 for 205 crore population expected in India by 2050 AD. Hence, it is necessary to generate additional irrigation potential by transferring surplus waters from surplus river basins to deficit river basins of the country. This is called as interbasin transfer of water or interlinking of Indian rivers. What is the need of interbasin water transfer in India? India has monsoon type climate. 85 to 90% of river flow is there in just monsoon months, June to September. Small rivers almost go dry after monsoon, whereas flood is a recurring phenomena in some of the states of Northeast India and North India. Many times, one third of the country is affected by drought in a particular year. So, this shows the water resources potential in river basins of India. So, I will just give the figures. In Indus, utilizable surface water is 46 km cube. In Ganga, Brahmaputra, Meghna system, 274 km cube of water is there, which is utilizable. In Godavari, it is 76. In Krishna, it is 58 km cube. In Suvarnarekha, it is 6. Kaveri, it is just 19. Brahmani, it is just 18. Mahanadi, just 50. So, we find again that in Ganga, Brahmaputra, Meghna, highest utilizable surface water of 250 km cube is there. That's why we need to transfer this Ganga, Brahmaputra, Meghna system water to the South India, where rivers have very less water, like Narmada has just 34.5 km cube, Tapi has just 14.5 km cube, and so on. So, the broad objectives of interbasin transfers. First is the equitable distribution of water resource available with us. Second is self-sufficiency in food and hydropower. Next is providing livelihood and employment for rural people and food self-sufficiency. This can be a broad objective. Government is working on the proposals which are given by the National Water Development Agency, and these are the interbasin water transfer links which are proposed by NWDA. Some of the links are completed, some of the links are under construction, some of the links are not yet started. So, for example, this is a link 6. Link 6, the Yamuna Rajasthan link. Say, this is a link number 4. It is the Sarada Yamuna link. This is the link number 3. It is Gangdak to Ganga link. So, in this way, shown by the red colors are the links which transfer the water from foothills of Himalayas and those rivers to the south up to Ganga. Now, the excess available water from North India is proposed to be brought to the South India through link number 10, that Ganga, Damodar, Suvarnarekha, and thereafter from Mahanadi to Godavari along the eastern coast by link number 15, that is Mahanadi Godavari. Thereafter, link number 16, Godavari Krishna, link number 17, Godavari Krishna up to Nagarjun Sagar, and thereafter, the link 22 will bring water from Pennar to Kaveri, and link number 23 bringing water from Kaveri, Vaigavi to Guntur. There is also a link between Krishna and Pennar here, and so on. So, This national perspective plan has two components. One is Himalayan river development component as we discussed, and peninsular river development component as we discussed. So just the Himalayan river development component. Himalayan river development component is such that it proposes construction of storages on main Ganga Brahmaputra rivers and their principal tributaries in India and Nepal so as to conserve monsoon flows for flood control, hydropower generation and irrigation. Interlinking canal system will be provided to transfer surplus flows of Kosi, Gandak and Ghagra to the west. Brahmaputra Ganga link will be constructed for augmenting dry weather flows of Ganga. Surplus flows available on account of interlinking of Ganga and Yamuna are proposed to be transferred to the drought prone regions of Haryana, Rajasthan, Gujarat. The scheme will also enable large areas of South Uttar Pradesh and South Bihar to obtain irrigation benefits from the Ganga with a moderate lift of say 30 meter. So, water transfer proposals of Himalayan rivers, north to south, these are the rivers Manas, Sankosh, Tista, Ganga, Damodar, Suvarnarekha, Maniprabha, and then the links will be rather from reservoir to reservoir. So, here this is a Manas reservoir, Sankosh reservoir, Tista barrage. These two Manas and Sankosh are proposed reservoirs. This is Tista barrage. Existing Farakka barrage, existing Durgapur barrage, existing again a new reservoir proposed as a Suvarnarekha barrage across Suvarnarekha, from which water will be transferred to the Manibhadra proposed reservoir, and thereafter it will be going to Mahanadi towards south. Advantages of Himalayan river development component: about 30,000 megawatts of hydropower will be available. 140 cubic kilometer of additional water will be available, which will be sufficient for 22 million hectares of land in Ganga Brahmaputra plains apart from Haryana, Punjab, Rajasthan. It will provide sustained minimum flow of 1120 cubic for navigation in Ganga, and scheme will also benefit Nepal and Bangladesh. These are the links in the peninsular river component as we discussed. And the peninsular river development component, it consists of Mahanadi and Godavari link. It is proposed to have terminal storages on Mahanadi and Godavari rivers to divert surplus flows from Mahanadi to Godavari. Further, transfer surplus from Godavari system to watershot rivers, namely Krishna, Pennar and Kaveri. The link from Mahanadi to Godavari will be along the east coast and will not involve any lift. The link between Godavari Krishna will be partly by gravity and partly by lift of 120 meter maximum. The transfer of water will enable irrigation in drought prone areas of Maharashtra, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu by successive exchange. Peninsular river development component proposes to divert part of waters of west flowing rivers of Kerala to the east of irrigating drought prone areas of Tamil Nadu, bringing new areas under irrigation Kerala to construct storages and interlink small rivers flowing along the west coast, enable partial release of water from Tapi and Narmada, which may allow extension of irrigation to Saurashtra and Kutch, extra water to Bombay, that is Mumbai, as well as providing irrigation to some coastal areas of Maharashtra. Interlinking of southern tributaries of Yamuna like Ken and Chambal, constructing small storages in the intermediate tributaries and dams Yamuna at Panchanath. So this is a schematic showing water transfer in the peninsular river component from Mahanadi. So dotted rectangles show proposed reservoirs, and these rectangles show the existing reservoirs. So Mahanadi to Godavari water will be transferred at Dhauleshwaram barrage. So two storages are proposed at Inchampally and Polavaram. Then links from Inchampally reservoir to Nagarjun Sagar, link from Polavaram reservoir to Prakasham barrage, and these are the existing dams of Almatti, Srishalem, Nagarjun Sagar, but water will be received in Pulinchintla reservoir in this way. Here there is a Prakasham barrage. Krishna to Penner links will be starting from Almaty and Srisalam, and ultimately what will be collected in Somasila, from Somasila what will be transferred to Grand Anikat, from Kaveri another link will go to Gundar. What are advantages of Peninsular River component? Additional 84 cubic kilometer of water will be there, which will benefit Orissa, Andhra Pradesh, Maharashtra, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Madhya Pradesh. It will provide additional irrigation benefits for 13 million hectares. Let us discuss the financial aspects. The cost of implementation of NWDA's proposal for interbasin transfer of water for both the Himalayan as well as peninsular components at 2002 price level, it was 5,60,000 crores. So present cost in 2020 may reach even up to say 20 lakh crores. Out of that, this is the power component and remaining is required for the irrigation and water supply. What are challenges anticipated in interbasin transfer of water? First is the existing tribunal awards of different rivers will get disturbed. It means Krishna Tribunal Award, Kaveri Tribunal Award, all those are going to get disturbed. The states may not agree with surplus water. We know that decisions regarding water resources are taken combinedly by central government and state government, because the water resources is a subject in both the lists, the state list as well as the central list. Appropriate rules and fresh regulations will have to be made. The difficulties in land acquisition due to limited land resources will be a big challenge. And further, satisfactory resettlement and rehabilitation of the people who are likely to be expelled due to this scheme will be again a challenge. Objections are anticipated from environmentalists also, and we'll have to satisfy them also. What are the technical problems? Pumping large quantities of silt-laden water over high heads during monsoon will be a technical challenge. Construction of high embankments, long river crossings, seismic safety of high dams, especially in Himalayan regions, will be another technical challenge. Huge power requirements for lifting water is one more technical challenge. So, reflection spot. Himalayan river development component of interlinking of rivers will make additional water for use through interbasin water transfer. The quantity will be, these are the options. Answer is 140 billion cubic meter. Himalayan river development component of interlinking of rivers will produce additional irrigation potential. These are the options. Answer is 22 million hectare. Peninsular river development component of interlinking of rivers in India will produce additional irrigation potential of, these are the options, answer is 13 million hectares. Conclusions: location specific solutions shall be finalized for interbasin transfer of water. It means from state to state we'll have to work. The basin shall remain as a planning unit for water resources planning of a country. The regional non-co-basin and state interests shall be required to be safeguarded so as to fully meet the other encompassing challenges. Long distance interbasin transfer will become unshakable part of Indian strategy for having strong agricultural base. We need to popularize the national perspective plan in spite of various difficulties. These are the references. Special thanks to Walchan Institute of Technology, Solapur, IDP in Educational Technology, IIT Bombay. Thank you.